I was going into this morning wondering what kind of response we were going to have at worship this morning, because on Mother's Day, usually everybody comes to be with Mom and the kids are singing, but it's also the day after the Derby when everybody is home, because too many people had a lot of time partying and were reacting to that. So I didn't know what we were going to have today, so it was good to see everybody here with us this morning. Who have survived Derby and are here to celebrate this loving day. We do have several announcements this morning. First, our condolences go to the family and friends of Carol Steele, mother of Melanie Davis. Carol passed away on May 3rd, and her memorial service was held this past Friday. And also, the flowers on the altar are in living memory of her mother, Louise Milton, by Jane Milton. May is our month for the food pantry. Please take note of that. There's also an announcement about Krispy Kreme donuts. Confirmation kids, if you have confirmation kids, we are having a rehearsal and dinner on Friday. We'll be here on Wednesday. I'm sorry. The kids are meeting here at the church at 5 p.m. and you can pick them up in the education building at 7 p.m. There are a bunch of other announcements in the bulletin. I will let you check out at your leisure. And also right now, Joy Knopfmeyer has an announcement about the repair.
Thank you.
another worship. I invite you to respond after me. Yesterday we watched the race.
Yesterday we watched the race.
But the winner, they were not able to keep the pace.
They
saw the horses walk on sod. But today we gather to worship God. We celebrate our mother's love. Which comes from God above. Let us worship God together. Amen. And let us sing hymn number 56, For the Beauty of the Earth.
Good morning. Today is Mother's Day. It is also the celebration of the Christian family. Welcome, everyone. Thank you.
You all did a great job singing. You want to all put your hand up like this, turn around, and pat yourself on the back. Good job. Very good. All right. Now, moms, on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being great, what number are they?
10.
10? What is it? 37.
93.
93.
Thank you.
meditation of our hearts. Be acceptable in your sight, O God, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Have you ever noticed when we hear words, and words almost always seem some statements to have a reflexive response? Like, early to bed, the first words that come to mind are early to rise. Although I like early to bed and late to rise, but that's just me. Or when you hear the words of any saint, what do you think of? How about don't count your chickens? Don't put all your eggs. A woman's place.
She knows this is a child of Israel. She
She knows this. She can tell by the type of basket, by the type of clothing, and he is circumcised, and it was only the Jewish boys who were circumcised. And she knows what had happened. She knows it was her father who had sent these children out to be butchered. She knows her father was the one who ordered them all killed. And she knows instinctively the right thing to do for the glory of Egypt is to drown this child. She knows this. But her heart is filled with compassion. This is a 3-month-old baby. And she does know what to do. Meanwhile, the other girl comes out from hiding. Those words, "Do not talk to anybody. Stay out of sight. Mind your own business," have just gone flying out the window. And she goes, and the daughter of the Pharaoh looks at her and begins to speak to her also. And the words her parents told her were, "Stay out of sight. Do not talk to anybody. Mind your own business." Also go flying out the window. And the two girls begin a negotiation. They begin a negotiation as to what is to become of this baby. And the Pharaoh's daughter decides, "I will take the baby, I will protect the baby, I will raise the baby, he will be fine. But I need someone to nurse the baby. Do you know anybody who could nurse the baby?" And the Pharaoh's daughter was not a fool, and she could think of only one person who would be following the basket, observing and negotiating. She knew it had to be a relative, a sister of this baby. And so she asks the question, "Do you know anybody who you could get to nurse this baby?" She knows the answer. This girl does know somebody. And she knows that somebody is going to be the child's mother. And so to the Pharaoh's court goes a Jewish baby being nursed by his own mother. After a negotiation between his daughter and this boy's sister. "Mind your own business. Do not talk to anybody. Stay out of sight. Come straight home." Nowhere in there was a negotiation, "Bring home stray babies." Nowhere in this negotiation was, "Get your brother to be amongst the Egyptians." Think about these two girls for a moment. These two girls, maybe 12, 13-year-old girls. Do you know any 12, 13-year-old girls? We have a bunch of them sitting here today. How many 12, 13-year-old girls are here? Please stand up. These are the girls who negotiate. Thank you. These are the girls who negotiate. And you know what they do in the process of this negotiation? They change the world. They change the world because Moses survives, and the entirety of what happens from then on, from that moment on in the Bible, comes as a result of a negotiation between two 12-year-old girls. Two 12-year-old girls negotiating at the side of the river who didn't listen to their parents on that particular occasion. Which is not a reminder to tell you not to listen to your parents. They're usually always right. But on this particular occasion, these two teenage girls who do not listen to their parents change the world. A woman's place is they can change the world. What the Bible tells us. Mother's Day is a day we celebrate not only mothers, but we celebrate women. The women keep changing the world in the Bible. There are women who rise up and do amazing things, acts of power for the rest of the Bible. And when God has to introduce to the world his Son, the Word of God made flesh, He has to talk to a girl first. When Jesus comes back from the dead, he appears to women first. The women in the Bible are always busy changing the world. And I hate to say it, the men are busy taking credit for it. Life has changed so much. That was sarcastic. The role of women, a woman's place, is often to change the world. Sometimes as mothers, sometimes as moms. Help us honor them and realize they are in our sight. They're quietly changing the world, blessing us with God's presence this day and all days. Amen. And Wendy Swisher's brother, if you didn't hear, has been diagnosed again with cancer in his shoulder, but now found it in his jaw as well. Yeah. Lindsay Brown's father. We prayed for that day. For Joyce. Everybody survived the Derby. All right, the kids' worship last week. I don't know how many of you were here last week, but the kids' worship was awesome. They did a great job. And yesterday, our youth did the soup kitchen and the confirmation kids endured 4 hours with me. But also people from the upper room class, several who shared their faith journey. So it's a really moving experience. And the kids did a wonderful job. Excellent job for both the youth choir and the chair choir and for that. Great job. Nancy Holt is back after knee replacement surgery. She was thinking of singing a solo but decided not to at the last minute. And Susan, you seem to be doing better. Is there anyone else who would like any other joys who would like to pray for? Yes?
My brother and his wife had a baby girl, Madison, this past Wednesday.
Okay, your brother and his wife had a baby girl, so you and Shelly are now aunts. An aunt? No, an aunt and uncle. It's been a long morning. Anyone else? The morning prayer I have today was actually written by a, seems appropriate, a woman in 1904. Her name was Mary Stewart, who was a high school principal in Colorado, and wrote one of my favorite prayers. of God from all pettiness. Let us be large in thought and word and deed. Let us be done with fault-finding and leave off all self-seeking. May we put away all pretense and meet each other face-to-face without self-pity and without prejudice. And may we never be hasty in judgment, but always be generous. Let us always take time for all things, and make us grow calm, serene, and gentle. Teach us to put into action our better impulses, to be straightforward and unafraid. Grant that we may realize that it is the little things of life that create differences, and the big things of life we are as one. And Lord God, let us not forget to be kind. Amen. Let us pray the prayer Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Mother's Day is a day that reminds us of generosity. It also reminds us of the generosity of God. Let us share our gifts of God with one another.
Thank you. Guide us, O Lord, in our decisions and in all that we do. Help us to use this offering to please you. Let us be your hands here on this earth to nurture, teach, and spread your good word. And thank you, Lord, for giving us mothers this day and all days. Amen.
I invite everyone to commission each other as we join together and say, let us go forth.